We're going to look at the role of agriculture in economic development. So first of all, agriculture is one of the most significant contributors to the economy. The sectoral composition of GDP indicates the level of development of a country. So if the dependence of the country's economy is more on agriculture, then it's usually seen as a sign of backwardness. And then we have agriculture as a source of livelihood. So agriculture is the main source of livelihood to a majority of the population, particularly in developing nations that has most of its population in rural areas. So the share of employment in agriculture decreases when they develop non-agricultural activities to absorb the fast-growing population. The developing countries usually have a large population, particularly in rural areas, and so if the share of employment in agriculture decreases, then it means that they are developing their non-agricultural activities and they are absorbing the fast-growing population in those areas. And this helps reduce the poverty in the countries. So, in a country which is predominantly agricultural and overpopulated, there's greater inequality of income between the rural and urban areas. So, in order to reduce this inequality, it is necessary to give more importance to agriculture. So, the prosperity of agriculture would then raise the income of the majority of the rural population, and this disparity or the inequality in income can be reduced to some extent. So now let's look at the food security aspect. So food security, it exists when all people at all times have physical and economic access to sufficient, safe and nutritious food to meet their dietary needs and food preferences for an active and healthy life. So it means that people have sufficient amount of food. So we can categorize that in four way. So one is availability. Availability means that there is sufficient quantity and quality in the supply of food. So this is dependent on the domestic production, food stocks, imports and foreign aid. And access is when individuals and households have adequate resources to obtain the available food. So this means that there's equitable distribution of food supply among everyone. The third aspect is utilization. So utilization means that food is nutritious and can be adequately mobilized and used by the body. And finally, there must be stability, meaning that there's permanent and durable access to food during all seasons. For example, if there's a famine or something, the country should have a stock of food so there's no shortage of food, and also maintain the economic stability. There should be no fluctuations in prices. So the supply of food should be adequate and it should be stable in all economic conditions. Then we have agriculture as the engine of growth for industries. So this can be looked at in two different ways. One is agriculture can provide raw materials for industries. For example, if we're talking about a ketchup company, then it means that there needs to be tomatoes in order to produce that ketchup. So then the raw materials are being provided for by the agricultural industry or the agricultural sector. And there also needs to be a demand for industrial goods. So when industries are developed, agriculture provides a source of employment to people in rural areas, and with that they can have sufficient purchasing power in order to have efficient demand for industrial goods. So the development of agricultural sector would increase the purchasing power of these agriculturalists, and it's going to provide a market for the increased production in the non-agricultural sectors of the country. And because agriculture is being developed, there's also increased scope of foreign trade. Agriculture, it plays a vital role in both internal and external trade. When agricultural goods are being produced in one part of the country, internal trade helps in relocating that agricultural produce to another part of the country, and infrastructure and transport grows along with that. And there's also foreign exchange earnings coming from agricultural sector. And if a country has increase in its exports, then it means that it's doing good economically. A country also needs to have self-sufficiency, and therefore relying more on imports for their agricultural products, it's not beneficial. And finally, we have capital formation. So underdeveloped and developing countries, they need large they need huge amount of capital for its economic development. So when the economy is at its initial stages of development, then agriculture, it's the most important source of capital formation. So agricultural sector provides funds for capital formation in these ways. So there can be agricultural taxation, export of agricultural products, collection of agricultural products at low prices by the government and selling it at higher prices. So this is being followed by Russia and China. But in countries like India, for example, the government buys the agricultural products at a fair price to ensure that farmers get sufficient fair income for that, and sell it at lower prices to the people in the form of, let's say, food distribution through ration shops, so that people who cannot afford it are able to buy it and have sufficient access to food grains. And it also maintains buffer stock of the agricultural goods so that it can help with food security during times of food shortages. And there's also labor and disguised unemployment in the agricultural sector, meaning that more people are being employed in agriculture than it's actually required, and the marginal productivity of an additional unit of labor, it's going to be zero or negative. And this is largely confined to agriculture. It's viewed as a source of investable surplus, in the sense that the human capital can be transferred from farm activities to non-farm activities. So on the whole, agriculture plays a very important role in economic development. So it contributes to the national income. It provides livelihood to a majority of the population, particularly in developing nations with a large population and with a large amount of people living in the rural areas. It's also a source of food security, to make sure that food is available, accessible, and it's being utilized, and also plays an important role in maintaining stability of food supply. It also acts as an engine of growth for industries and also creates market for industrial goods. It helps in foreign trade and increases its foreign exchange earnings. And finally, there's also capital formation because of the agricultural sector.